Today we're going to go through reconfiguring an Atronic cash line machine. It's a Sphinx 2. And everything is working fine, except we need to make some changes to the software. Right now it's set up as a penny machine, where you buy $1 will buy 100 credits. But in fact, we're using a nickel cabinet that's 9 lines and 5 coins per line, max bet. So we need to reconfigure it, and today I'm going to show you how that's done. One little tip I'll show you that might be helpful when you're going to do this. Farther down the road in this process, you're going to need a config chip, and to help you find the correct config chip you're going to need for the software, it'll show you what configuration is in it right now, and you can do that on the side of the machine. You have a key and a key switch. By turning that key switch, we'll bring up the service screen. And we're going to choose the first one that's highlighted, configurations. We're going to choose the middle button to enter it. And on this list, you will see configuration version, CKRDW-AB. That's the config chip we want to use to reprogram this machine. All right, let's get started. First things first, power off. Eject your board. We're going to use a master reset chip. It goes in location U2. Always pay attention to the notch in the end of the chip. The chip will fit both ways. One way works and the other way will burn the chip up. So pay attention. You can see the notches on the chips in the board. They have to be the same. So we're going to take out chip from location U2. We're going to insert our master reset chip. Take your time. You don't want to bend any of the legs on the chip. Make sure it's fully seated. Notches are the correct orientation. Now we're going to reinsert the board in the machine. Power it up. Once you hear that sound, you know it's cleared. Now you can power it back down. Eject the board. Now we're going to remove U2. And we're going to reinsert the chip we took out in the first place. Again, making sure of proper orientation. Watch those notches. Power it back up. And now we have our config CRC error, which is normal, and that's what we expect to see. Now there's a few more steps to finish reprogramming the machine. We're going to power it back down and take the board back out. This time we need to take out U6. This is the pay table, and this is the slot that you will insert a configuration chip. It's called the config key. Notches are correct. We'll reinsert the board. There's a lot of different choices on config keys. If you guessed right, it'll tell you so. If you guessed wrong, it'll also tell you so. And now that's the correct message when you have the correct config chip. It'll give you an error message if you don't have the right config chip, and you just got to keep trying different chips until you hit one that it does detect. So now we're going to turn the machine back off and take the config key out and put the pay table chip back in. Take U6 back out, or excuse me, this one. All right, notch is in the correct position. We're going to power it back up. Now we have the RAM error, and to clear that, we're going to press and hold the button on the MPU board. Just push it and hold it. Now it's clear. Still more steps to go. So we're going to calibrate the screen. Now we need to set the coin in value. This machine, it only accepts dollar bills, ones, fives, tens, paper money. So we're going to go down, we're going to set it coin in value at a dollar. And we're going to tell it that it's a nickel machine. So for a dollar, it'll give 20 credits. We're going to use the buttons on the front here. And we're going to bring it down to the $1. And then the enter button is cash out. And I'm going to bring it down. The multiplier is 20. How many credits do I want for a buck? At a nickel, I want 20. Cash out. I want the dollar symbol. Dollar buys 20 credits, nickel a credit, that's exactly what I want. I'm going to choose OK. Cash out. Drop with bills is fine. Games is fine. This all looks good. I'm going to cash out. That all looks good. Cash out. I don't like it to display currency. I like it better when it's displaying credits. So I'm going to press that. Bring it down to credits. Cash out. Fading feature disabled. Cash out. 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 Here's where you need to make a change. This machine, and most likely yours as well, this is the type of bill acceptor. We have a JCM. This is what a JCM looks like. It's WBA. So if you have this JCM dollar bill acceptor, you need to tell it that's what it has. So we're going to go down to JCM. Cash out. Cash out. And there's a little summary of all of our settings. Looks good. Cash out. How many reels? 5. Cash out. How many lines? Well, that's going to be determined by your button panel. I happen to have 9 lines on mine. If you were setting up for a penny machine, you might choose 20, but this is a nickel. I need 9, so I'm going to bring it down to 9. Cash out. What's the max bet per line? I need 5. That's what my legends on my button panel say. So I've got 5 highlighted. Cash out. We'll go for the 94%. I like it to win a little more often. There's a summary of our settings. Cash out. Everything looks good. Now we're at the point, we're almost done. There's some things we need to tell it. We need to tell it that we do not have a hopper. And we have to do that using software on a laptop and a dongle and a special Atronix serial cable. My laptop doesn't have a serial output, so I've also adapted USB cable to serial, and then I use another adapter to go from serial to get it to communicate with Atronix. They have a special pinout on their cable, and later on I'll show you a diagram so you can build your own. They're pretty easy to build. You don't have to go find one and buy one. These are some of the things that you'll need to connect your laptop to your Atronix cache line. You're going to need a hard lock for the software. You're going to need the software called main config, and you're also going to need a cable to get from your laptop to the serial port on the slot machine. This is what the software looks like that you'll need in order to communicate with the machine. But make sure, if you do buy this, you also have to have the correct dongle to go along with it. The software will not run without the appropriate dongle. It looks for it every single time you run it. And this is the cable that you'll need to connect your laptop to the slot machine. My laptop uses USB. I don't have serial ports on mine, so I have a USB to serial adapter. And Atronix, like I was mentioning, uses a special pinout on their serial cable. So you either have to buy their cable, or you can do like I did. I started with a regular cable, cut the end off. I bought a replacement end at Radio Shack, and I was able to wire it the same way as the Atronic cable would have for a pinout. And now we'll start connecting things. So we're going to plug the USB cable in. We need to put our hard lock in. And we're going to open up the main config software. And you'll find there are options on here that you need to set. So this particular port that I'm plugged into, I know is COM port 6. And if you're wondering where your setting should be, you can go into your start button, control panel, device manager, and you'll see COM ports, ports COM and LPT. Open that up and you'll see USB to serial cable COM 6. Yours may be COM 5, COM 4, COM 2, but mine happens to be COM 6. And then there's another setting on here, the main setup version, the CNF12. Where do I get that? There's a drop-down menu of other choices. You have to go to the screen on the slot machine. It will tell you, use PC program CNF, and it might be 12, might be 13, might be 14. Today we're using 12. Now on the logic board is a serial port. We're going to plug into that. And we need to use our buttons on the front. When you start out, hardware configuration will be highlighted. And the center button is functioning as an enter button, so I want into that. And you'll see we have a message that says start transmission on PC. I need to come over here, a little behind here. Hardware config. All I want is to tell it that it has a bill acceptor. It doesn't have a hopper, it doesn't have a coin acceptor. That's all I want it to do. And I'm going to choose upload, but I've waited too long. I got to go back over here. I got to hit the enter button, and I need it to say start transmission and quickly come over, pick upload, transmission active. Transmission successful. You can see on it listing coin acceptor no, bill acceptor yes, hopper no, printer no. Above it, it's showing the old configuration the way it was. And now we have our new one. So once you're happy and everything is good, you can use this button and arrow down. Keep going down to quit. Hit that as an enter. And it says hopper failure, check connector is very normal. It's still looking at its old configuration. I need to shut the machine off, power it back up, and that will clear. Okay, it still says hopper failure, check connectors. We've powered the machine down, powered it back up. Now we're going to go inside. We're going to press the reset button. And I'm just going to shut the front door. It's ready to go. Done.